Good evening. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to introduce my friends. Thank you for coming. This is full of place. Thank you very much. And from my left side, our drummer. If you see big drum, it's both sides, mountain goat skin. And he made it for himself. All the instruments, all the, our ancient traditional instruments by skin, wood, horse's hair. He also very good singer, of course. And eagle player, please welcome Alexei Sareglar. I play also instruments, how I call it, eagle, a little bit doshpulur, a little bit guitar. My name is Bapa Sayan. Thank you very much. Founder our group, our man who knows very deep our traditional throat singing styles, also some ancient story, legends, songs, of course. He also some compose our songs just in traditional way. He also one of the our best singer in Tuva. Please welcome Kaigalo Hovanen.
Thank you.
And flute player, you see later and hear it, instruments called it Byzantchi. It's very ancient, our traditional instruments. Before the most our instruments, he came to our music culture. He also very good throat singer, man. Have beautiful, usual kind of voice. It's very smooth and soft. And please welcome Radik Tulush. If I talk about our ancient instruments, of course, we are singing also our traditional songs. Came from the, I don't know, we are doesn't check this time. It's from long time ago. First song, we are called it prayer. Usually oldest men and go to top of mountain and start to pray. Of course, about the folks, about the nature, and just get, also ask it from the eternity blue sky father, from the mother earth, as for better life. We are calling this song Burgu. And second song we are playing straightly, we are calling this song Ancestors Call. Of course, about our people who give for us. It's ancient type of instruments, ancient type of singing. We are calling this style of singing Humi. Men do it simultaneously, two or three notes. It's make it drone, and especially you need to keep your breath and long drone. And top of the drone, make it melody like flute. All the time with us, it's our spirit, our heart. And after the beautiful lyrics, of course, it's all the time have allegory between human being and between life. It's style who's singing now this. Radik Tulush singing this style, call it Sagut. It's Herder main song, of course, about the love. Sagut.
Oh, yeah.
ない。俺がまだまだまだまだだろう。
It's played with different type of instruments, one song, and improvise around the words, around the melody. Now we are singing a song called Chorahor, means yellow trotter, a song about the special rhythm from the horse moving. It's made it by all the instruments. It's a song about our hero, of course, who's singing for the horse, like for the friend, about the life, about the traveling.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Song we are playing before is came from the around the 17th century. Now we are playing more old song from the 12th century. It's also changed instruments, tuning. It's like usual. And this song about the one of the most beautiful lady in this ancient time. It's she's from the rich clan. We are thinking one of the poor guy making this song, and he want to be eagle and fly up to her, just looking how she's beauty. It doesn't have chance. It's like, yeah, she's from the rich clan. It's she's so nice. Everybody love her. Lady from the clan of Sarilar.
Oh.
Folks, about the people who ask a chief. It's a song from the 15th century. People ask a chief, where is our friendship neighborhood, where is our big territory, where is our better life? It's called the song Hongoroi.
Thank you.
it's twice, it's not so big country. We need to be friendship with neighborhood, of course, or fighting. It's, it doesn't matter, it's how much we are, it's how many we are. It's like if we are three of us, we are friendship around us and it's kind of strong enough from spirit. As we are ready to fight with 30 people, it's some words like about the warriors, how this he ready and how this strong if we have around him these friends, family, clan. It's all called the Tujilin Beast or Tujilin Beast. Now a lot of thanks. It's thank you for good sound, for good crowds, and thank you very much. We have now intermission 15-20 minutes. See you later. Good evening again. During the first part, you hear it some in song, our low sound from our voice. It's also one of the type of our singing, call it Tah Kargarazi. Usually men sit front of the mountain and singing with effect of mountain, with echo. Of course, about our beautiful mountain around the Tuva, we have ringed by mountains, call it Altai, Sayane, Tanliula. This song about how all this type of singing came from the kind of from internal to internal. It's rolling my sound, it's from my ancestors. It's words about this type of singing, call it Tah Kargarazi, singing by Kaigavo Hovalik.
Oh,
Thank you.
Song also about our people who travel by camels to the Beijing and come back. It's song about the long trip, about the homesick. We are calling this one Camel Caravan Drivers.
Oh,
Happiness love story from the Herder Man. We are calling this song Kerbiakse, Sairakse. It's man, like usually he say this, I'm definitely come back to you, you just need to wait me. I need some business in the taiga, in the forest. And you just, my sweetheart, you just wait me, I'm definitely come back. It's Kerbiakse, Sairakse.
Yeah.
Song about the if it means something, do it, and something thinking he want to be make it best for the life, for the clan, for the family. A song about this feel about the life, call it Kongurvoi.
Oh,
Now we are playing a song, it's very special for us. It's a song about the place where it's a sacred place for Tuvan people, for Orianakh people, where we start our biggest Siberian river called Denisai, which means Mother River. Also where we start our nationality called Orianakh people, Tuvan, and also where we start language. It's a song about the hunting man who proud, who honorable, about this place of Intua. We are calling this one Gudugen Taiga.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for coming, for listening carefully, for respect our music. We have now last song, of course, about our tour. We are calling this song Karachi de Kyo. It doesn't mean it's just how men sit in the horse and just this make it worse. It's kind of for the good moving. It's faster up in Tuman, up in the mountain, go to the sweetheart. It's called Ash de Kyo. Thank you. also wanted this kind of wild sound. Yeah, how I drive my horses, of course, you need this like strong voice enough. End of summer, start of autumn, we have celebrated our friend being too knows some people, whereas we have celebrate called Nadim, whereas people meeting and sit together and play and make it competition, different type of competition. Is horses riding and competition by wrestling and who make it best yours, who make it best traditional foods or drinking stuff. It's from the milk produces called it Haraka. And this song also about the jealousy for the better horse who best driving all the time. Sometimes it's not good feel, yeah. We are called this Ekiatar, fastest and good.
My name is Alexei Saraglar.
My name is Bapa Sayan.
My name is Kaygalol Hovalık.
We have started a long time ago, it's like early 19s, 1990, with Kaygalol, with my brother, and we have played before also, and it's late 70s. We have played this with traditional instruments and a little bit some push to also electronic instruments, just from long time ago. It's how we are meet together again. It's 1990. It's, we are start to do it something more deeply and more kind of find it real sound of our instruments. We are many of these instruments lose or lost. Yeah. And before the generation it's have this hard time, it's revolution time, it's kind of destroyed mostly instruments, it's mostly. And we start to do it something and travel around the tour and some find it old songs, talking with old people, how we need to play, how we are singing some songs, try to find it. And start to do it, some recording also. First recording we are making in London, in England, in 1991. And also very have information, some heroes in America, from the one of the scientists at the musicologist from the Dartmouth University. Also inviting him and inviting us to hear. Just we have been before in Swiss and some in Europe, but just in the United States we have started from 90s. I'm starting a little bit older and like now how I've been in theory. So these guys is some from childhood. Usually this, if you hear it from the childhood, it's I've started how I've been younger and just not used and just tried it. That's all. I mostly like the instruments. How say, you see, it's you really feel what is how you understand by words, by songs, by instruments a little bit deeply. For me, it's I've started to grow up with different music, you know, I play this guitar and so on. And how I'm really touched deeply in my traditional and my instruments. I've started to hear it more better since I'm better. I'm grow up inside in the college, like Alex said, he does our education, it's real. How I learn music is kind of, I've hear it 1 year. Now I'm here to like pop for 2 years. This is important for everybody, I think. It's why this in our traditions don't have special education or kind of if you're talented, you need to sing, you know, or you usually maybe some, if you hear German or usually agro-cultural law, kind of, it's, you, if you're man, you need to try to sing like that. It's from childhood. Try to repeat this, your grandfather, fathers, uncles, around your brothers. It's kind of game for starters, like game. You introduce birds, dogs, sheep, cow, yaks, and here also you hear it, you try to do it. And it's very additional, it's kind of another type of side of our throat we are using. It's another muscles, usually if you are everybody we are talking, singing, rock, opera, whatever, it's like it doesn't work. In our situation, we have started to do it, this kind of wake up, some muscles, and some making tension, some muscles. It's real, special technique. Not, it's, now we are talking about technique, it's more kind of emotion.
фигуришу.
Ты потом переведешь.
Да, да.
Что вот когда вот он услышал этот раз разговор о том, что вот от деда, от дяди, от братьев, угу. Услышал это, ну ему это нравилось, и как бы сказать, тоже завидно, вот так хотелось этого тоже.
Как тянулось, да?
Да, это какое мужское достоинство, потому что в этом есть. На лошади научиться, или как-то вот связать тебя с этим, как тебя. Да, а когда получилось вот такие первые звуки, ну, радость не описывается.
He says that having heard it around from his uncles and father, grandfather, it's he had a strong inclination to try to pick it up, a yearning, a pull towards it, and it's as he mentioned, men surrounded by it are drawn to pick up these sounds, and when you get it right the first time, it's a very pleasurable and enlightening feeling.
Фамилию это семьи, как сказать, тоже мне вот брат, который тоже пел, он быстрее, чем я, научился, поэтому все время я
за
ними. Потом на инструменте он начал играть тоже. Я тоже перешел тоже на инструмент. Эти моменты, это такие,
очень приятные. Запоминаются.
За брата бегали. He's saying, his brother saying, and he was always just a little bit ahead, and he would always try to catch up, and his brother started playing the instruments, and he picked them up as well.
Wonderful.
It's a greatly pleasurable thing to pick up this when you finally get it.
So I kind of, it's not special for the artist, you know. It's just artist, it's okay, the talent more. It's usual people, drivers, I don't know, this is homemakers. Who want it? Who want it? If you men, you need to drive horse, you know, you need to honor. If you men, you need to do this. It's just for yourself, not for public, not for family, you know. You just be alone and sick. It's like your feel, your spirit.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
We are doesn't check. We are trying to with Ted Levin from Dartmouth. He professor teacher finally also literature or something about this. No, it's just some Greek, you know, Herodot.
Вот
они же путешествуют.
Да, да.
Централизм, то есть в те времена они уже слышали.
Да.
В Сибири там как раз они ездили, тоже они говорят, есть какой-то народ, они что-то там орут, рычат.
Да. Что-то не.
Да.
He's saying even in Herodotus' time, when they were traveling through Central Asia, they heard these people with these voices. So there's no strict recordings, but it goes far, far back.
Yeah, wow.
There's a piece in the Patina. He's saying a lot of the history is lost to time because it wasn't recorded for various reasons. But
it's just generation by generation, like childhood. Studies. It's like usual music education. If you need to real, try to make it best. If you mean, try to make it best. And you do it this all the time. It's kind of for yourself, not special, but for yourself. You know, it's very sensitive. Your muscles heal. It's totally broken if you go wrong. Just you need to be careful. It's like you just for feeling. It's sleeping course, it's real. То есть мы были в университете в Нью-Йорке, и там нам камеры в рот и в нос совали, то есть смотрели, и это все происходит. И это очень такой инструмент хрупкий.
Да.
То есть если что-то неправильно, там можно порвать, и там, сшивать невозможно. Мышцы вокруг нормальных, которыми говорим, там поем, все. А есть еще такие фальшивые связки, их называющие спящие там, связки медицинского. И вот они как раз говорят о том, что их возбуждаем, или напрягаем, или расслабляем. То есть знаем эту технику, все обычно это происходит.
He's saying they actually went to a university in New York and they did camera inspection and they had, we have these latent muscles that normal people don't use that they're activating. He's also saying it's very delicate, can be easily torn if you're using it correctly. So it takes a lot of finesse and practice to not only harness these muscles, but not destroy them. Лечение какое-то нужно после? Это
не, ну конечно, тяжелое. Надо просто нет, это просто надо просто относиться осторожно, и все. А. Так мы, естественно, там не прямо так, как оперные вокалисты, там да. Чем-то не ухаживают. То есть, но у нас благодаря этому нет ни ангин, вот таких простудных вещей, то есть это нас не трогает. То есть просто надо беречь себе, конечно,
да. Все. He says it's more just a careful approach in general maintenance.
Потому что здесь постоянно, если видишь кровообращение, то есть нормально, достаточно, то есть у тебя все тонус. Тут такие вот, я вот признаю, что я не болею ни тензонитом, вот они хотя раньше были. А вот этих я смотрю, таких симптомов, так практически не все, то есть простудный муж по телу бывает. Вот.
I said that actually are rarely inflicted with issues of the throat.
Oh, wow.
Because of this,
То есть, да, здесь какие-то вибрации все равно, это что-то там напряжение, все это фунит, то есть оно не дает.
Кровь, наверное.
Да, по себе просто, это же напряжение или расслабление, все равно, то есть гармонизируешь как-то.
A lot of tightening and loosening of specific muscles to accomplish the harmonies. And...
Ну, я сказал, я говорю, ты знаешь, это работает на внутренние уши какие-то. Организует, вокруг. Да, и вокруг ты слышишь уже, я тебе говорю, что я до этого увлекался, конечно, там, разной музыкой, и все, и у меня определенно есть музыкальный.
Да.
Но когда я начал сам заниматься вот этим именно, то есть очищая горло, то есть вот эти все, уши по-другому стали работать, и музыку воспринимаешь эмоционально уже на каком-то более тонком уже путем, потому что тебя это организует раз, потому что тебя полностью ты контролируешь, сам производишь звук, все эти вибрации, и уши начинают работать очень сенситивно, и как сказать, можно сказать, уже открываются. Благодаря этому я могу и сказать, что детям или там просто людям учиться этому, понимаешь, потому что просто, чтобы слушать нормально, вот и все. А так, чтобы не обязательно петь, там, где-то ходить, там все. Просто для себя, потому что странно, когда спящие какие-то связки у тебя есть, когда ты что-то спит.
Что-то там не работает.
Да.
Есть, но не работает. He's saying primarily it's a matter of being surrounded by it and practicing the instrument and coming to understand all these muscles and latent things that you just don't even use and find them. And, your ability to hear, to sort of understand that music enhances. Changes as you learn it more because you're making all these new sounds and new harmonies and everything, so your sense of understanding about it expands as well.
Sign by
Thank you.